6A schoolmates will show how the transformation can save it from disappearing. Please welcome Valana, Liu, and Joseph.
Another neon sign being pulled down. It's such a pity.
It's a tremendous loss for Hong Kong. Don't you think they're beautiful?
Yes, I think so. Neon lights is a very special kind of Hong Kong visual arts. All the details are carefully designed by neon sign makers. The patterns used in different signs represent different kinds of shops. Cow, fish, and chicken represents restaurants, while cameras and phones represents shops about technology. The neon light designers use different frames such as Gong Zi Kuan, Feng Yan Kuan, and many more.
Have you forgotten the fonts? Different font lights are also a part of the design, like Dan Ngao, Sir Ngao. The beauty of the fonts are also an attraction. In the old days, the words on the signboards were drafted by calligraphers. The fonts such as Kai Su, Dai Su, and Ngai Bei Tai were commonly used. That is what makes neon lights so special. But when were they first used?
Well, I know why. I know when. In 1898, British scientists William Ramsay and Morris W. Travers discovered neon gas. The first commercial neon light sign was produced in 1912. Its appearance was beneficial towards advertising using glowing signs and the replacement of light bulbs. With further development, neon lights were turned into magnificent neon signboards with different colors, shapes, and patterns we see nowadays.
Looking at the breathtaking neon signs would surely attract customers. Not only their use for advertising, they created the exceptional scenery full of lights that no other country has. Walking on streets like Nathan Road to sightsee neon lights is definitely something visitors enjoy appreciating. Neon lights have become famous tourist attractions and even gained the reputation Oriental Pearl for Hong Kong.
How wonderful! Can you imagine how amazing it was when neon lights were all over Hong Kong? In the peak time, there were over 100,000 neon lights decorating the city. However, there are probably less than 1,000 neon signs left in Hong Kong now. They are mainly distributed in 5 districts, Tsim Sha Tsui, Jordan, Mong Kok, Prince Edward, and Wan Chai. They are beautiful, but many of them have been removed. Do you know why?
Of course. Neon lights are facing a series of problems. It has some unfixable flaws. The constant buzzing coming from the signboards causes a big amount of nuisance to the local residents. Other than that, the traditional neon lights also have safety issues. The glass tube containing the gas would leak, and fixing them is costly. So most owners would just tend to ignore them, which caused to lack of maintenance. Some just turned to use LED lights and other materials.
The main reason why many of the neon signs were demolished was the implementation of minor work control system by the government since 2010. There were thousands of neon lights being pulled down since then. One of the most recent and striking examples is Tuck Hing Street. Once a street with neon lights shining all around, now the whole street looks dim and cold. Neon sign's unique dazzling scene has been vanished into history.
Another problem of neon signs is the passing on of the skills. Left alone, neon light master Wu Qi Kai has already been making neon signs for over 35 years. Thinking that making neon lights is easy, but it is actually not. Making neon lights needs blowing and bending tubes using fire, which requires a unique skill that has to be learned for at least several years. Master Wu said very few teenagers have the patience to do this kind of job. That's why neon light masters are lessened.
We feel really sad to see the neon lights disappearing from the streets in Hong Kong. So we decided to do something about it. That is why we chose neon lights as our FYP topic. First of all, we want to promote neon lights as they are fading away now in Hong Kong. Secondly, we want to preserve it as official tradition and to maintain the shine of those neon signboards in our city.
To get more information about neon signs in Hong Kong, we interviewed Mr. Brian Kwok, the assistant professor at the School of Design in the Hong Kong Polytechnic University. He is working on a project about neon lights and have written a book, 霓虹暗色, 香港街道視覺文化紀錄. It is a very useful reference book for our project. Mr. Kwok also shared with us his thoughts towards the extinction of neon lights and also gave us some tips for our topic. We were so amazed to see the manuscripts of the neon lights which were donated by a neon light company he showed us.
In order to promote neon lights and let our schoolmates know more about them, we also organized a neon light walking tour. Luckily, nobody fell asleep. We took 5 schoolmates and their parents to 5 neon light signboards in Yau Ma Tei, briefly introducing the history and design. Now, let's take a look at the video we took during the tour.
We are now to the 4th place, which is Lijing Sauna. This is a place for children. 所以是不適合我們小朋友去的，但我們都想介紹一下那這個招牌，就是因為那個招牌很特別的，就是看到這個是一個倒轉了的 L 字，還有另一個這個也是紅燈招牌，就是一個橢圓形的紅燈招牌，它們的背景都是一個間條線來的，還有圓形那個橢圓形那個紅燈招牌的字體就是單勾，就是我們 原本字的正常寫字就是一筆過寫上去，但是這個 L 字型那個就是雙勾，就是另外一條線就是去包住那個原本那隻字，而且它的位置都很特別的，通常都會放一些很搶眼的地方，但是它這個就放在一個樓底下面，就是來吸引那些走經過的路人。
Special thanks to our attentive tour guide, Jason. Our guests were really amazed by the neon light signboards. We have successfully aroused their interest and concern on neon lights.
To echo our school theme, transformation, we started to think about how to transform the traditional neon light. To our surprise, neon signs are already transforming. While walking in the shopping malls, we have noticed a lot of small, modern neon signs in shops to attract customers. We found some neon lights home decorations available, though they're not cheap. Furthermore, some artists have incorporated neon lights into their artworks too.
Thanks to technology, neon lights are off with a bright future. In America, a company is inventing a new kind of neon light called incision, which is safer, cheaper, more effective, and can save up to 92% of your energy consumption. We appreciate if the government could set up policies to preserve the traditional neon signboards so our city can shine again.
During this 1 year's time, difficulties on researching, organizing tours, and time management were tripping stones we encountered. However, with our group members' 100% effort, we could conquer those difficulties.
Through this project, our group members' potential and hidden talents have been unleashed by involving in different tasks. We learned that teamwork and cooperation are very important, and we became more mature.
To conclude, even though Hong Kong now is very advanced, it gives people a cool feeling. Unlike Hong Kong back then, with the neon lights on, it gives you hope and warmth. We Hong Kongers should never forget but to appreciate neon lights which brighten up our city. We will promote eagerly to fight back its glory and transform it to make its popularity rise.
That's all for our presentation. We are FRP 6A Group 2. I am Valena.
I'm Joseph.
And I'm Li Yu.
Wait.
Well, you've heard us talk, and we want to hear you talk. So when I say neon, you say lights. Ready? Neon!
Lights!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, 6A. It's inevitable that certain things and places will be gone when the city is developing. Especially in Hong Kong, our living space keeps reducing. That's why one group of schoolmates explored how to make a better home with more space by transforming the furniture. They have designed several plans of their dream house.
Another group have learned and created some apps and devices.
They tried to put technology into urban farming and help our school's organic garden. All these development is for one purpose, a better future for mankind.